Toyota, the world's largest car manufacturer, has severe problems in the Teknikens Värld Moves test. Two generations of Hilux has almost flipped over. And now we're driving the RAV4, the fifth generation, and we really want to see, is this car secure? Have they done their homework? Will it perform in a good, safe manner? Let's test. Fifth generation of Toyota RAV4 performs really bad. We find an ESP system that doesn't limit the car's movement. There's a bouncing effect through the test, which makes the car really hard to handle. And that's at a speed of about 67, 68 kilometers an hour. We should point out that we've tested two different Toyota RAV4s with the same result. The specification is the same, with the same type of engine, gearbox and four-wheel drive. The only thing that differs is the color. To better illustrate how poorly the RAV4 performs, we'll show you the performance level of two competitors. First out is the front-wheel drive Nissan Qashqai, which performs at an all-time best ever level for any test car through the Moves test. Maximum speed is 84 kilometers an hour, a marvelous result, mostly thanks to a fantastic working ESP system. The large and heavy Kia Sorento weighs 2,620 kilos fully loaded, or about 400 kilos more than the Toyota RAV4. Despite this, the Kia Sorento manages 78 kilometers an hour thanks to its safe and easy to drive behavior. Once again, the ESP system makes wonders for the big car, and the behavior is miles apart from the bad behavior we find in the Toyota RAV4.
It's really, really bad. The best car in this test performs at 84 kilometers an hour. Toyota, the world's largest car manufacturer, you have some really, really important stuff to focus on in the future. We've already seen the Hilux problems twice. We don't want to see it again with RAV4, so back to the drawing board.